I'm head of the Art, Architecture and Design School at the University of South Australia. I'm Danish, so I did my first architectural studies at the Royal Danish Academy of Art. And then I followed that up with postgraduate studies at Columbia University in New York. We get a lot of the students coming to this school saying that they or their parents have contacted practices before and said, which school should we go to? Which school should our kids go to? And many of them are saying, come to University of South Australia. All in all, we have about 90 staff in the school and probably about 70 academic staff. And I think that my colleagues make a really interesting team.
It's a real privilege to be able to be at the opposite end and imparting some of my knowledge and helping students develop the skills that I wish that I had had when I'd left university.
I've been taking photographs and teaching now for 20 years. One of the greatest collectors of photography on a personal level in the world is Sir Elton John, and he saw some of my work and he bought that, and that was a really nice affirmation that I could sort of be in that collection.
I've just completed two exhibitions along with other colleagues as part of a research group called the Digital Art Research Experiment, and we exhibited in China last year.
My own experience from furniture design has been involved both in commissioned work for public and private institutions, and that's also spread into surfboard design, which has been the latest area of my energies over the last 5 or 6 years. I've recently accepted the position at UniSA, having spent the last 11 years in the United States, and I was employed at the Rhode Island School of Design, one of the top three design schools in the world.
I've been a practicing architect in Berlin, London and Tokyo. I used to have my own office in Berlin for more than 10 years, and before that I studied in Germany, I did a master, then I studied at the Architectural Association in London, and I did a PhD at the Technical University in Berlin. It's very interesting, the concept we developed here in the architecture school is the integration and the synthesis of research in sustainability, and how all students on all levels, bachelor, master and PhD, conduct research. This is probably one of our leading strengths.
There's absolutely no doubt that the students recognize the expertise of our staff and appreciate the teaching they offer and the research they are doing.
Many of the projects that students work on aren't just about developing sort of interesting ideas and concepts, they actually go to fruition and implementation. That is incredibly valuable student experience.
One of the things that's really important to this school is in fact that developing that nexus between the undergraduate program and our suite of postgraduate programs. The other thing that's really important to us is our relationship to industry.
I think there's a real danger if you say to someone, well, look, you're not really professional until midnight on the night you graduate, and then you can worry about it then. Well, I think that's too late. So one of the things that we do here is we try and introduce students to as much as possible in the relation to the medium itself.
So the more we can connect them with the various aspects of design that will happen in their professional career, the better is the education for them.
On one side there is teaching excellence, on the other hand there is research excellence, and our research in sustainability and impact of climate change on cities is world important, world considered, recognized, and we do a lot of publications in this field.
The people who are teaching our students have been building buildings themselves or being artists or designers in that way. So the students love that because they feel that they really know what's going on out there.
I think one of the great things about UniSA is the breadth of possibilities. And our facilities here, I would say, are the finest in Australia.
International colleagues who have seen our workshop facilities and our studios are amazed at how good they are.
And this actually means that we're able to not only reach the boundaries of what we do in practice, but also push the boundaries in industry as well.
One of our former Malaysian students was a runner-up for an international competition in New York, which was published worldwide. So the quality of the models or the artwork that the students are doing is now very high quality, because they have this very up-to-date equipment they can use.
Some of my students in particular have gone on to be world famous portrait photographers and advertising photographers and fine art photographers, and that's really rewarding.
And I think one of the most important aspects of any educative process is that the students are being given a set of skills that's going to allow them to be flexible and agile in their professional career.
A little publication that comes out in Australia every year, it's called the Good Universities Guide. And that goes through all the universities in the country, and it rates different aspects of the different courses. And in an area like architecture, for example, we are the only architecture school in the country who scores top in all the different areas which they rate. And we are one of the few schools that has almost absolutely full employment.
We are a growing nation, cities are expanding, so studying sustainable design opens up all kind of career options as architects, as urban planners, as environmental engineers, sustainability managers, and advice on large projects. So if you want to do research in sustainable design and green architecture and green cities, you should come to the University of South Australia in the School of Art, Architecture and Design.
Australia has that kind of let's give it a go attitude. So as an architect and designer, you have a lot of opportunities in Australia.